the long and winding road that leads to your...
Okay, this is the Beatles' Long and Winding Road off the Let It Be album. Specifically, it's the acoustic version that I've put into the embedded section. We have a capo on the second fret, and if I reference any chords, then it will be referenced as though there's no capo. So it makes it a lot easier for me, because I don't know chords very well. Okay. Okay, so that's the verse, and there's two variations on the verse. So we'll just go through it. The first part is built around a B minor. And then we move to a G major 7th. It's just the third fret, and we have the third string and fourth string on the fourth fret, and the fifth string on the fifth fret. So. Second fret, so we're only playing the second, the third and the fourth strings. Then we move to a G, so we're adding the first string 2nd fret and the 2nd string 3rd fret. Then we move to a F sharp. It's an F sharp minor, I think. And we add the 2nd string 3rd fret, and back to the B minor, and then a run down, so from the B minor, run down off this 5th string, play the 6th. It's an E minor, and then a partial A. So we take this E minor formation, and we just shift it down one string. Okay, and the next bit. Just a 3rd string 2nd fret, and we just play the 3rd and 4th strings, so we move from 3rd string 2nd fret, playing the 3rd and 4th strings, we add the 4th fret on the 4th string, move to the fifth string. We'll play the fifth, the second fret fifth string, and an open third. So once again. Third string, second fret, and the fifth string, fourth fret. So we're only playing the fifth, fourth, and third strings here. So we simultaneously play fifth and third string. And we hit the open fourth. So back to a G. Back to our F sharp minor. Run down again, back to E minor. So here we're playing an A7th, so that's just the second string, second fret, and the fourth string, second fret. Second string, third fret. To our D. So. Now the variation on that is at this point. So so when we move from this G, so instead of we play down. Now we move into the chorus.
Many times I've been alone, and many times I've cried. Anyway, you'll never know.
Okay, in this part we look at the chorus. I actually left one of the choruses out in the video in the embedded section, so I'll add that in now. So this one's simply running from a D. To a D, but we're playing the F sharp on the sixth string instead of the first. So E minor seventh to an A seventh. So D to G. D, E minor 7th, to A 7th, and then we move back to the B minor on the chorus, on the verse, sorry. The other part of the chorus is the I think it's the orchestral arrangement where there's a kind of a crescendo as it builds up. I play that like this. So we start again on this D, and we add this F sharp on the bottom, just on the sixth string. The D again, and this time we're going to play the F sharp on the first string as well. And then we're going to go back to the G again, and we're going to play the G on the first string. I've actually been playing it like this. You can play it like this if you like. So. Then back to the D, G up here, so, to G, to B minor. Seventh, I think. And we add the fifth string. Oh, sorry, the fifth fret on the first string. And then we simply move this finger down to the fourth fret on the third string. So, we're barring the first, second, third, fourth strings here. And then we move back to our B minor. And I just chose to finish on this, which is just first, second, third strings. And that's about it. That's all the components you need to build the song.